So, wir sind mittendrin.
And right in we're right inside it.
EQ, the IQ,
emotional intelligence series.
Und wir hatten jetzt schon zwei
and
Themen.
We already
Freude
have two topics: joy and sorrow.
Um
and today,
Wut.
We're talking of anger.
Das ist ein spannendes Thema. Das ist gut, sagt jemand.
It's, it's
gut,
a good topic. We know that this anger. We know that anger is not good, right?
Und bevor ich richtig einsteige mit dem Thema Wut, würde ich gerne allgemein über Gefühle reden.
I just want to talk about feelings generally.
And hat jeder Mensch Gefühle?
Everyone has feelings. Every one of us have feelings.
Viele von denen sind echt schön.
And some of these feelings are beautiful.
Viele von denen sind auch nicht so schön.
And some of them are not beautiful.
Letzte Woche Trauer.
Some like last week sorrow or fear.
Es gibt auch Gefühle.
There is also fear, feelings like hunger,
Müdigkeit,
or tiredness.
Dann
it's not so beautiful,
Liebe,
some of them. Some
have
like
Freude,
joy, love.
Es gibt Gefühle von
there's feelings for
fühlen,
belonging among people.
Wenn man gern warm hat, ist das ein schönes Gefühl.
Ja, it's a wonderful feeling to feel loved also.
Gott hat uns geschaffen mit unseren Gefühlen.
God has created us with all these feelings. It's part of us.
Aber
but
gleichzeitig ist es auch so,
at the same time,
dass so schön unsere Gefühle auch sind, es ganz schnell passiert, dass unsere Gefühle mit uns durchgehen.
Our feelings can be contrary to us, right? There's the confusion between how we feel and where we don't want to be. Sometimes our feelings really make us just finishes us.
Und es ist wie als würden sie uns kontrollieren.
And it's good to know how to control our feelings.
Nicht so gut. Da möchte ich heute
mehr
drüber sprechen.
Some of our feelings are not so good, and that's what we want to talk about today.
Die eigentlich sagt,
we wanted,
dass Gefühle,
someone said that feelings
Lauf geben sollen,
should not be allowed to just run away. Have you heard that saying before?
Immer wieder kommt,
that's, ja, we need to know that feelings will always come to us.
Und, du merkst,
but you know, you notice that you try to protect yourself against this feeling. You try to, but you don't have energy. You cannot really control this feeling.
Weißt du, was dann unsere Gesellschaft dazu sagt?
You know what this the church says? It says that you are an authentic person.
You are
not. You know that's what the society tells you that you are not truthful with yourself. The society says, let it go out of you. Just follow your feeling. You know that's a super thing to do. You have a feeling. Just leave your feeling. Everything that is not the correct thing. Just fulfill your feeling. Have you heard such things like that? For example, anger.
Und das ist alles and so unehrlich,
a feeling,
wenn du nicht deinen Gefühlen Raum gibst.
That really makes you down.
It's,
I tell you, the society is wrong to tell you to show forth all your feelings. That's why I'm so happy that we know people that can control their feelings. Because, imagine,
ich bin dankbar und will's mir gar nicht
vorstellen, I say I'm very grateful to have
Politik haben.
Imagine politicians, we have lawyers, we have judges, we have police. People who do not live according to this motto of just living out your feelings. Maybe I just come around, I just come to
you
because I just lock the door and say everybody should stay outside. Are you happy here to know that at least not everyone lives according to his feelings? I am happy that our society is different. There are many societies where people are encouraged to just do whatever they want, to just follow their feelings. But I am grateful that I live in a country that at least there is some control. And I also thankful that the Bible tells us to overcome our feelings. And I want to show us the truth that is in the Bible, that your feelings are not always correct. Your feeling is not the truth. Sometimes you feel happy and sometimes you feel sad, but they are not always the truth. There are so many types of feelings that you come to you. There are situations like hopelessness. Sometimes you're just powerless in some situation. But I want to tell you they're not true because God is always hopeful. God is always God always have energy to give to us. And he can change our situation. It's not how you feel that is the reality. It's not the truth.
Oder du fühlst dich total
maybe
traurig,
sometimes you feel sad
keine Hoffnung mehr.
And you don't have any hope anymore.
Du denkst, alles ist vorbei.
And you think everything is
Am
over.
Gibst du dir jetzt die Kugel.
And dann maybe just Gefühl, shoot yourself.
Real an, aber es ist nicht die Wahrheit.
But I tell you that's not the truth.
Situation. Ich habe das vorhin gesagt.
Because God
Gutes draus machen.
Can make good things out of this situation.
Und vielleicht bist du hals und Kopf verknallt.
You are happy.
Die Schmetterlinge gehen mit dir durch und du hast nicht nur eine rosa Brille, sondern tausend und
das
fühlt sich super schön an.
Yeah, you're feeling so good.
Das Gefühl ist nicht immer die Wahrheit.
I tell you, it's not always the truth.
Sagen, hey,
because people around you say, hey, hey, you're just in a dream. You're just dreaming. That's not the truth.
Und deine Gefühle gehen mit dir durch.
And you're feeling that way, but that's not always the truth. And it's just the moment.
Deswegen ist es gut, auch Ratgeber zu haben in bestimmten
Situationen. It's always good to have someone to advise you.
Viele Gefühle,
there are many different feelings that is not real.
Die Frage ist immer
the question
wieder,
is,
wie gehen wir mit diesen Gefühlen um?
How do I handle these feelings?
Und sich schon mal bewusst zu machen, dass Gefühle nicht immer die Wahrheit
and
sind.
Since we know that feelings are not always the truth, my first point is,
wichtig, du hast vielleicht ein Gefühl,
maybe you have a feeling, or you are a feeling.
Ja, du bist nicht das Gefühl.
Oh, you are not the feeling,
nicht,
but you have a feeling.
Hast,
maybe you just imagined it before.
Thema Wut, was wir heute
like,
haben werden,
like for example, we're looking at anger today. Have you been angry
ja,
before?
Auch,
yeah, a lot of people in this room, yeah.
So
but you're not an angry person.
Und ich kann vielleicht mal Trauer empfinden.
Maybe you're a sorrowful,
so
but you're not a depressive person.
Ich kann manchmal
I can
das Gefühl haben,
have the feeling
zu sein,
to be challenged,
unverlässigen Person.
But I am not a person that you cannot depend upon.
Und uns bombardieren Gedanken
maybe
und Gefühle,
every day you have these feelings that bombard your mind.
Ja, vielleicht bist du auch richtig sauer
maybe sometimes you're angry with someone.
Und es bezieht sich alles auf dich selbst.
And you start thinking that, oh, it's your fault. It's,
wie ein Versager.
And you feel like a failure.
Und dann zu merken, hey, das
then you begin to notice, hey, that's not the truth.
Und dann auch zu sagen, hey,
and
ist ein Gefühl, was
I want to tell you, you just have a feeling. It is not your identity. I am not a failure. I just have this feeling. I am not sorrowful, even if I am not lonely, even if I feel lonely. I am not hopeless, even if I feel this situation of hopelessness. You must learn to distance yourself from your feelings. It helps to know that I have this feeling. It comes from outside, but it is not. I am not this feeling. This feeling. Is, does not determine my identity. This feeling cannot become my identity. This feeling will go away. It's good that it might be sorrowful, it might be happy, but it's going to go away. You have feelings, but you are not that feeling. It's very important for me. And today I'm talking about anger.
Ist ein Gefühl, das
it's a feeling
übermannt uns manchmal.
That sometimes overcomes us.
Männer haben damit mehr Probleme
men
als Frauen.
Have more anger problems than women.
Folie, ich weiß nicht, ob du den Film gesehen hast.
Maybe you've seen this film drauf. Before.
Da ist dieser eine Charakter.
This character
rot und
is red
wütend,
and he's always angry.
Im Kopf von den Personen so mehrere, ja, da ist
and he's been in the head of the people
Trauer,
for many years. Sorrow,
Wut,
fear and anger. And I forget
und
some
Wut
of the things.
Kommt
and anger
Einsatz, darum geht,
always comes
ne?
around when,
Ordnung zu sprechen oft oder mal seine Meinung deutlich
if he
machen,
wants to really talk about his own idea,
so, ja,
and
so
then it begins to burn,
bam, kommt die Stichflamme
and
und
the flames just come on his head.
Ist die hat jemand den Film gesehen?
Have you seen that film before? Someone seen the film?
Okay,
some people have seen it. It's a nice film.
Schaut euch den mal an.
Just watch the film.
Und Wut ist so ein
and
Ding.
Anger
das ist
such a thing.
So. Das ist so eine der Emotionen, die wahrscheinlich die stärksten sind,
that is so strong,
die auch sehr stark uns in den Bann nehmen,
die comes very strong
nach außen gehen können.
And quickly go away.
Is
an is a feeling that can really that can really move things in our hearts and bodies.
Und das ist eine Emotion,
and it's an emotion
von uns,
that every one of us know.
Niemand getroffen, der nie wütend war.
I have never met someone who was never
und
angry.
Und das Ding bei der Wut
and
ist,
this thing about
es gibt
anger
so
is that
viele Auslöser
there's so many things that
so
can make us
Gründe,
angry. There are so many reasons to get angry.
Es gibt dir mal 10 Sekunden und wahrscheinlich
in 10 seconds you can just get angry.
10 Gründe, wütend zu sein.
And you can have 10 reasons in 10 seconds to be angry.
Meine Liste wird zu lang, aber ich fange
my an. List will not be so long.
Hey, mich macht es wütend und ich oute mich.
I get angry with things like this.
Wenn ich Auto fahre,
if I'm driving,
und vor mir ist jemand langsam.
And somebody is too slow in front of me.
Mittlerweile regt es mich auch auf, wenn jemand 50 in der 50er Zone fährt.
I'm angry when somebody is driving 50 in the 50 zone.
Das ist mega sympathisch, vor allem auf dem Ring. Und dann denke ich, hey, warum fährt er 50?
Why is he driving 50?
And vielleicht bist du aber auch ein bisschen älter und du regst dich eher auf, wenn dich jemand in der 30er-Zone überholt.
And
ja?
So you are angry when somebody overtakes you in the 30-Zone.
Mich macht es wütend, wenn mich jemand passiert, weil erstmal denke ich, der ist sowieso falsch. Yeah. Der kann nicht recht haben. Wo ich übertreibe da, ich habe da auch
schon... You know, I'm just talking, I'm just making too much fuss about it.
Wütend, wenn mein Computer langsam ist.
Sometimes I get angry when my computer is too slow. How many of you get angry when your computer is too slow? You press a button and nothing is happening and it's so slow. It's not what you want.
And
you're looking, the program is going to start shouting, what's this?
Und ich muss sagen, ich lerne jetzt immer mehr kennen.
Diese I'm learning to go around this. It's really sad. I hate slow computers.
Feuer, yeah. Aber
but
was gibt's noch für Gründe? Was
what are the reasons?
Nachbarn.
Your neighbors.
Ein paar lachen da.
Some people are laughing. hey.
Wir haben bevor wir hergezogen sind, haben wir eine Situation gelebt.
We had a situation.
Also zwei Parteien in einem Haus.
Und we were in two BM families in a house and our neighbors.
Eine Persönlichkeit. Und wir hatten immer wieder Streit.
Always had
also
quarrels.
Sogar richtig böse. Bis dahin, dass er uns bei unserer Vermieterin verleumdet.
Sometimes our landlord had to come into it, the situation.
Zum Beispiel irgendwie.
For example, we had.
Hatten auf jeden Fall viel Papiermüll.
We renovated the room and there were lots of paper. And we tried to put it into the dustbin and try to squeeze it in there. And then our neighbor came.
Und meinte so,
hey, and said, why are you people stuffing the dustbin with so much paper? And we're thinking, hey, what's the problem?
So, ja, wenn du das machst,
and I say, if you do that, then we cannot close the dustbin. It was just making a fuss out of it.
And
we're saying, why are you discussing over such tribal things?
Folgendes passiert.
You know what happened?
An den Straßenrand.
They put the container outside on the road,
von oben leer.
And it was almost empty from the top.
Quasi schon an der Tonne.
The neighbor was waiting there at the container, the dustbin.
Ja, ihr lacht jetzt noch, ne?
And you're laughing already, right?
Und sagt dann, hey,
and he says, hey,
gesagt.
I said to you people,
ja.
I told you,
doch gesagt.
I told you,
hab ich recht gehabt, wo?
I was right, right?
Kennt ihr so Leute, gell?
Yeah? Do you know people like that?
Ich hab ihn in den Arm genommen, gesagt,
I just embraced him, I said, hey.
Nee, hab ich nicht.
No, I didn't do that. I knew that maybe he actually said that with the people who came to take the trash away. You know, I did the following thing. I went inside. I called those people. I said, hey, you have forgotten the dustbin. You people need to come back and pick the one in my house. And I was so happy that he
keine
came
Ahnung,
back.
Ob das stimmt, aber es waren auch andere nicht so schöne Situationen.
It was not actually a good situation. But sometimes neighbors can make you angry, right?
Ja.
Yeah.
Arbeitskollegen oder Chefs.
Your colleagues or your bosses.
Kennt ihr das?
Do you know that?
Der Arbeit.
When you work.
Das ist das beste Klima, oder?
That's the best environment, right?
Ich glaube, viele I believe kennen das, dass man auch da sehr wütend sein
people
kann.
Know this situation of anger in the situation in the office. Personal things that have been eaten from the refrigerators.
Der Chef ist irgendwie unzuverlässig.
Maybe
und
the things you planned in the office
und
not going the way it should be.
Ungerecht behandelt.
And sometimes you feel that we're not justly handled.
Und so
there's so many situations we can get angry about.
Und wir denken, hey,
and we think about it.
Recht darauf, wütend zu sein.
Hey, I have a right to be angry. I have a reason to be angry.
In der Bibel steht, in
the Bible says,
20,
James,
der Zorn des Menschen bewirkt nicht, was vor Gott
chapter 1, verse 20, that the anger of man does not work the righteousness of God.
Der kann aber ruhig stehen bleiben.
You can keep that.
Lass dich nicht vom Zorn und Wut überwältigen.
Do not be overcome by anger.
Gehst du schnell ins Unrecht. Wer sich schnell erhitzt, macht Dummheiten.
The person that gets angry quickly would do stupid things. It's not difficult to become angry.
Maybe
do you notice this anger that begins to rise in you? I know it personally. There are some people, they just get angry very quickly. They have a lighter skin for anger. Maybe for people are from the south.
Bin halb Kroate, ja,
people
auch.
Who I'm half Croatian.
Temperamentvoller ist. Aber es gibt verschiedene
people,
Auslöser für Wut.
There are situations that can really make us angry.
Ich möchte euch damit reinnehmen, was die Auslöser sind. Wir haben Nachbarn oder Verkehr.
We talked about our traffic, our neighbors.
Was ein Trigger ist, ja?
We need to note what our trigger is. Things that really make us angry.
Ich meine, weil manche Menschen,
some people,
nicht wütend zu werden,
they never get angry. So, and some people really get angry very quickly.
Und was hier steht, ja,
what says, it says here,
nicht, was vor Gott recht
anger
ist. Das bedeutet,
cannot
so viel,
fulfill the righteousness of God.
Sind,
it means that when we're angry, everything that we're going to do
nicht gut.
Will not be, everything that we try to do will not
entweder
be good.
Person an,
maybe you're angry with someone,
in der 30er zone und kriegst einen
Knöpfe, and maybe you overtake somebody in the 30 zone while driving.
Nachbarn,
and maybe you have anger with your neighbor for small things, and there's this tension between your neighbor and this distrust. Maybe there's domestic violence. Men who beat their women, and some women even beat their men.
And
and what are these things that trigger this anger?
Schlägereien auf der Straße,
beating people, fighting on the streets, two people in the church, all these things is the fruits of anger.
Sogar eine verrückte Story gelesen.
I read a crazy story in the traffic.
Da ist ein Taxifahrer,
a taxi driver
an,
was staying in front of a construction place and he was waiting for the traffic light and it was green and as was going through, the other taxi driver quickly came up and overtook him and this taxi driver and he started noticing anger. He drove with this other man. As the other driver stopped, he went up to him. He went to him, to the front, and went to confront him and shot him. It's a crazy world which we live, right? I'm sure that this person did not handle his anger very well. Anger can be catastrophic and can be so destructive. It can destroy a lot of things. You know, when we show, when we express our anger, especially people who get angry very quickly and we begin to do things and become bitter, that things that we regret later, because anger is such a negative energy. It can destroy a lot of things.
Und es ist so gut, wenn man lernt,
and it's so good to learn how to handle our anger. Anger is not good. You need to understand, anger is not good.
Es gibt auch
there's also
Form von Wut, die
a type of anger.
Was sind Auslöser? Eine Sache, die ich wirklich witzig fand.
Something I really find interesting is,
is like
when people are hungry, they are angry.
Und, ich finde es in unserem Kontext witzig.
I think it's so interesting. Let's go to the next slide. I'm sorry for what I said when I was hungry. I'm sorry for what I said when I was hungry.
Yeah.
Hunger can make us angry. Maybe you know that feeling. Men are more affected with this statement. Than women.
Aber dann gibt es viele, viele andere.
There are many other points too.
Hunger,
insecurity, injustice, this feeling of helplessness. We talk about pride, insecurity, being hurt, or injustice, and impatience. Maybe you're thinking, I didn't deserve that.
Beste Verteidigung ist der Angriff.
You know, people say the best form of defense is attack. I want to talk about this. At the end of the day, maybe we're talking about traffic or the road or anything. All those things has to do with impatience. Impatience really makes us quickly angry. You know, in impatience, if you're an impatient person, you're going to get angry about a lot of things quickly. Maybe people that you cannot understand, people that you cannot follow through with, you quickly get angry with them and because you lose patience. Maybe your colleague at the work, maybe it's not as fast as you and you start getting angry. Because you are impatient. I believe another way to be angry of anger is pride. You know,
und sie hat gesagt, ja Mike, bei dir ist wahrscheinlich 9
somebody said, somebody talked about, say, say, hey, you have to, Mike, you have to be talk about pride because.
Aber ist ehrlich. Ich bin dankbar, dass meine Frau ehrlich ist.
I'm happy that my wife really told me that I should watch out for pride too, because pride can lead to anger.
Habe ich doch nicht verdient.
Maybe you start thinking, I don't deserve that, and you begin to get angry.
Du denkst, du bist besser als
and you think that you're better than somebody else.
Person dann vielleicht was bekommt, was du
and, you, and this person got something which you deserve.
Stolz ist, dass du unzufrieden bist mit bestimmten
Situationen. You're, on, you're not satisfied with the situation because you think it should be better for you. I deserve better. That's what you're thinking.
Führt es dazu, dass wir wütend sind.
Pride leads to anger.
Or
when we're not satisfied about situation, with this situation, that it is a stupid situation. I tell you, the best situation is.
Ja, das ist, glaube ich, wenn du vor allem oft wütend.
Maybe you always get angry.
Dann könnte das mit Stolz zu tun haben.
Then I think you need to watch out for pride. Maybe you think you're better.
Entsprechend verhältst du dich.
And you begin to behave yourself in that way. And begin to behave like the boss to your colleagues, and this can lead to anger. You're angry because nobody's listening to you. All these things are related to pride. And pride can make you really angry. We have to learn to handle it. Insecurity is also connected to pride. You know, is that feeling? Having this feeling in you, you become insecure because there's a you have an identity problem, and maybe somebody criticized you, and you start thinking maybe somebody criticizes you and start getting angry, and you start thinking no, I don't want that.
Es gibt so Menschen,
there's people that maybe you know them, they come to you and say that something is not so good. And they start talking until you become so sad with yourself. Have you met such people? It's related to pride, to insecurity. Maybe you have this feeling that nobody should have said this to you. Maybe you think, hey, it's not correct. You cannot tell me that. You cannot just come to me and say such things. And you begin to attack and attack. It has to do with anger.
Wenn du dich darin selber gerade wiederfindest,
maybe
dann
you discover that is with you, but I will tell you to watch out for pride
eine starke Unsicherheit
or insecurity in your life.
Eine Lösung.
And these two things can really trigger your anger.
Unrecht, Machtlosigkeit,
injustice.
Das sind Dinge,
being hurt by other people. These are things that that can make us angry. Maybe something happened to you when you were a child. Maybe somebody did something unjust to you. And maybe you went to the law court and you lost the case. And you know, it makes you angry. It really makes you really angry. I hope you've not gone through this kind of anger. There are people that have gone through it. This anger, you know, injustice, maybe little or big things, especially when you cannot defend yourself and you know that this situation is unjust and you cannot help yourself. You cannot prove yourself that you're not, your hands are tied, you cannot prove that you're right. It really makes you angry, right? It really makes you angry.
Es macht einen richtig wütend.
It really makes someone angry.
Nicht, wohin damit.
And you don't know what to do with it.
Maybe
you start looking inside of yourself and say, this anger, this angry situation,
Sachen wie borderline oder
the anger is somehow like a solution where we look when we get to our borderlines. Things we cannot handle. And then we need a solution to this.
Würde ich mir gerne mit euch anschauen.
I want to look at the solution that the Bible offers. Let's look at it together.
Raus aus der Wutfalle, habe ich das genannt.
I put it as get out of your rage. Get out of your rage. I want to read something for you. Romans chapter 12. If you have a Bible, you can quickly open that. Romans chapter 12, verse 18.
Dann zahlt es niemals mit gleicher Münze heim. Seid darauf bedacht,
in den
Augen aller Menschen bestehen zu können, soweit es möglich ist.
Vers 18. If it be possible, as much as it lies in you, live peaceably with all men. Dearly beloved, do not avenge yourselves, but give place to wrath. For it is written, vengeance is mine, I will repay, says the Lord.
Handelt vielmehr nach dem Wort,
Therefore, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he's thirsty, give him drink. For in doing so, you will heap coals of fire on his head. Be not overcome of evil, but overcome evil with good.
Wisst ihr, dieser Satz, ich habe ein Recht darauf, wütend zu sein.
We have a right to be angry.
Wie gut wäre es, wenn du den umformulieren könntest in ich gebe mein Recht auf.
How good it is to say I do not I give up my rights to be angry. To say hey, I know I have a right to be angry, but I give up my right. I say I'm not going to be angry anymore.
Wenn du morgen hier sitzt und du glaubst,
if you're sitting here,
dann ist es der beste Weg, mit deiner Wut klarzukommen. Hey, das ist der beste Weg aus.
If you're here today, I tell you this is the best way to handle your anger.
Einer ist wirklich diese Stelle, die ich gerade vorgelesen habe.
I know someone. This Bible verse is for you today.
Kurz mit euch teilen möchte von
I'm going to also read some Bible scriptures from Paul. Jesus. Jesus was on the cross for our sin. He was crucified. He was brutally murdered. He was brutally killed. He was hanging on the cross. And you know what he said? Luke chapter 22, verse 34. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
I thought, wow.
Jesus had the right to be angry, to be angry with these people. The Pharisees came around and said, hey, you're the Son of God, why can't you help yourself? I imagine it. It's stupid to say if I was hanging on the cross, but I was thinking Jesus had the power to get down, to call on the angels, to come to this and show his power. Jesus was not powerless. He had the power to do that, but he gave up his right. He decided to love and say, Father, forgive these people because they do not know what they are doing. Paul,
jemand, der someone, ganz viele Gemeinden gegründet hat,
who established a lot of churches,
hat, um Menschen zu Jesus zu führen,
and gave his whole life bringing people to Jesus. He was in front of the courts one day in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 14. He said, Alexander the Smith, he did a lot of bad things to me.
Und dann sagt er,
and he said,
bei meinem ersten Verhör stand mir niemand bei.
By my first hearing, no one stood with me.
Paulus, der sein Leben geopfert hat für
that Menschen, gave his whole life for people,
zu jedem Einzelnen hatte, der dann selber in eine Notsituation
kam, that was in his, it was in many perilous situations, and he supported people,
für ihn beten,
and prayed for people. People left him.
Stell dir vor, du machst
just das, imagine, was weiß ich, that you're doing everything and you're giving everything and everybody deserts you. Paul did everything, but he had a reason to be angry, but he said, God, forgive these people. Because he said, Lord, forgive them because they do not know what they do. And Stephan, one of the false disciples, as the church was created, God really used him greatly. And finally, he was taken for the court.
Und er steht vor diesem Gericht der Pharisäer.
And he was in front of these Pharisees who were judging him and made him guilty. And they cursed him and said, you're wrong to preach the word of God. And you know it happens. And the Bible says that their faces fell. They were angry with him. And they drew him into the town and they started stoning him. To stone really is really, to be stoned is really painful.
And
it says in Acts of Apostles chapter 7 verse 59, and he prayed, take my spirit. And he went on his knees, verse 60. And he cried with a loud voice, Lord, lay not this sin in their charge. And when he had said that, he fell asleep. Those were his last words. He said, Lord, don't count the sin with these people. I read that and I start thinking, I said, these people, these men, they had reasons to be angry. They were in a situation where they were helpless, people were unjust to them. And their answers was, Lord, do not lay these sins upon these people because they do not know what they're doing.
Wisst ihr, wenn du
you know,
dich entscheidest,
if decide
dein Recht aufzugeben,
to give up your right to be angry,
then you're going to get to this situation
where people where people are touched and become conscious.
Dass du dir selbst am meisten damit schadest, wenn du wütend bist.
Because they get to this level that anger really affects the person that is angry himself. Maybe somebody is driving slowly in front of you.
Ich meine, du kannst es machen, dass es mitkriegt, ja, aber wie?
Maybe you just get angry at this person driving slowly in front of you.
Oder dir passiert irgendwas und du regst dich auf.
Or maybe you are really angry about something that's happened to you. But you notice that the anger is really affecting you. We are like prisoners when we are angry, and it affects us and not the people. Bad with sociology and with sociological analysis, but anger affects us more than the other people. And that is what Paul and Stephan is showing us. I believe that people who are angry with us or people who attack us because they're angry, people who are hurt by other people tend to hurt other people. Yeah, people who are angry, people who try to hurt us, it is because they have actually been themselves, they've been hurt by somebody else. Because they themselves have a problem. So if we look through it, we will learn to be merciful to these people. We learn to forgive these people. We learn to bless these people and say, God, help these people. Sometimes it's just good to say, hey, just say, God, forgive this person because he does not know what he's doing. To say, I'm giving up my right to be angry is the beginning. It's going to change the environment. It's going to change your life. It's going to change your work. It's going to change a lot of things in your life. What helps us to take this step is a practical tip. The next slide is to take a step back when things happen. It helps a lot.
Ich habe den Wieland gefragt, ob ich die Geschichte
erzählen darf. I asked Wieland when I was telling the story.
Das war jetzt erst in unserer Männerkleinen Gruppe.
It was in the men's small group.
Wieland wohnt jetzt glaube ich schon 14 Jahre in seinem
Wieland is living there some 14 years.
Neben ihm sind jetzt kürzlich neue Nachbarn.
And we are just new neighbors there.
Auch jünger als er.
And we're still younger than him.
Wenn ich es richtig verstanden habe, hat dann die Frau den Mann angestachelt, zum Wieland zu gehen, um Wieland mal klar zu machen, dass er doch bitte seine Hecke schneiden
soll. Okay, we went to meet Wieland to cut the grass across the grass in his house.
Denkt natürlich.
Then we came to him and he said, why are you people coming to me? Why are you coming to me to say this? I am longer here. I've been here for a long time. And he got angry. He was really, really angry. But before he exploded, he just decided, hey, I will just go inside my room. It's a good decision. He went inside.
Was für ein Idiot er ist.
Then he relaxed himself. Then he came back to the church, the men's group, and was saying, hey, I'm angry, but yeah.
Guter Schritt.
It was a good step.
Hilfe bei anderen suchen.
It's help. It's good help to relax.
Aber das ist ja eine gute Verpflichtung, wenn ich das öffentlich sage.
I hope I can say this in the public. He went to his neighbor and told his neighbor he's sorry and say, hey, he's very sorry.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Was macht es mit Wieland?
What
kostet ihm seinen Stolz?
What happened to Wieland? He lost his pride. And so what?
Habe ich eine Zacke aus der Krone.
No.
Gott wird ihn dafür belohnen.
God is going to bless him. The second thing is his neighbor was ashamed. At least
Der Nachbar wird merken, oh wow.
The neighbor is going to notice, hey, wow.
Angst, warum wir sowas oft nicht tun, ist, dass wir dann denken, wir werden dann Fußabtreter und die erlauben sich dann alles, oder?
You know, sometimes we always have this fear that we will lose our faces. But if we take a step to apologize to people, God is with us. And in such a situation, we can just be very light and very relaxed and say, hey, don't worry, I'm going to do it. It's a good step to apologize. And for me, I don't know if all the people who were there noticed it, but for me, I get emails. Sometimes, where people just write crazy things to me, and you start thinking, This is, they are taking it personally.
Kann sehr gut meine Meinung äußern.
Look, as a person, I can really say my opinion.
Oder wenn ich immer, I don't know if sage, hey, das war jetzt nicht richtig.
To really tell people, hey, what I feel.
Oft ist es so,
sometimes
so
it is, when I get an email,
and
it makes me angry, then I start thinking, why was this person asking me, why is he writing this?
Hey, und dann schreibe ich,
then I write with anger
klar ist, worüber wir gerade reden.
To talk clearly,
klar ist, wo ihre Grenzen
sind. To tell the person, hey, ja, you cannot just come and say this
so,
to me.
Dann lese ich das noch mal durch,
then I read my emails one more time. Then I say, hey, this is not good. Then I say, hey. Then I wait till tomorrow before I send the email. And the next morning when I read it, it's a catastrophe. Many times, I send it to my wife. And then I sleep over the mail and I think, hey, that's not the right way to have expressed it. It's not so bad. Why am I getting so angry? And I would have sent this email just that, you know, that angry that way. You know, many times it's so good to just take a distance back, take a step back. To really understand, why am I angry? Is it my pride? Maybe is it really wrong? We need to set ourselves free from our pride.
Dann sind wir erstmal mit Gott darüber im Gespräch.
We need to pray about things.
Dann kommen wir an einen Punkt, wo wir
when we do this, we get to this point where we experience the peace of God, and we will not get angry again. When we begin to radiate peace, is it not good that we would just relax and let the peace of God take over? In Psalm chapter 4, verse 5, it says,
sondern denkt nachts auf eurem Lager nochmals nach und schweigt.
It says, be angry, but do not sin.
Wenn ihr zornig seid, dann versündigt euch nicht.
If you're angry, but do not sin. In Ephesians chapter 4, verse 26. It's always good to relax and wait for God to take over, not just do things from your own strength. If you think that you have a reason to be angry, then just take a step back. It's going to change your life. Maybe you think, if you know that you have a problem with anger, then you need to get help for it. There are different things to do to help yourself if you have anger. Then you need to get help. Because anger destroys you. And God wants to help you. You need to look for help. So there's aggression training. Maybe you put a box there where you write things so that you got notes.
Müssen wir auch Luft rauslassen. Das ist vielleicht auch ein Zeichen, dass dein
Maybe
Leben nicht ausgeglichen ist. Ich muss auch gucken, hey, vielleicht brauchst du
noch to say to yourself, you need to step down on your anger. Something that stresses you to step down on that. Do not let anger ruin your life. Anger destroys. Anger destroys lives.
Mein letzter Punkt hier.
My last point is
mit dir selbst und mit anderen.
Is to be merciful to yourself and to other people.
Ich glaube, ganz oft reagieren wir.
I believe that sometimes we react with anger because we think we are right and something is making us angry.
Aber dann Gnade zu haben mit dir
selbst. To have mercy with yourself.
Zu sagen, okay, ich bin nicht perfekt.
To say I am not perfect.
Sich mal zurückzulehnen,
to take one step back and to say, hey.
To
be merciful to yourself, to say no, although I am angry, God still loves me. To be gracious, to be merciful to yourself. I'm telling you, you don't know what is happening inside a person. Also, to be merciful to a person really helps that person too. Because you don't know what the person is passing through. It can also help you to go in peace to bed in the night. I think we need to really be merciful to ourselves too, a lot.
Und das wird uns auch helfen,
and it's going to help us
to
meet with our neighbors and to be merciful to them.
Ich glaub, dass der beste Weg,
I believe the best way is to know yourself, to pray when you notice you have a problem, to talk to about other Christians about it, to look for help, depending on the level of anger problem you have.
Gefühl im Griff haben.
You know, we need to talk with people who can help us put our feelings in to contain them.
Ja, Selbstdisziplin.
We need self-discipline.
Wenn du Single bist,
if you're single,
umgekehrt auch.
If you're single, then you need to master to yourself to be able to control our feelings.
Und ich möchte abschließen mit
I want to close with
einem letzten, das ist der heilige Zorn.
Holy anger. Like holy anger. I'll make it very briefly.
Eine besondere Form.
It's a form of
Form ist der
according to Wikipedia, it says a form of anger to be angry about something that is unright. It's not about anger against people. The idea is not to be angry with something, but to handle things in a merciful way. Holy anger can be good if we use it to change things for good.
Positive Energie umgewandelt.
Anger can be possibly changed if we change it to holy anger. Yet, so to say, there are two types of anger. Two types of angers.
Und ein Zorn in der
and
Bibel, der ist sogar ein
one of the anger in the Bible, is talking about is,
he says,
when you are angry, do not be, do not sin.
Etwas wie Passion, Energie.
That means this passion is talking about energy.
Zorn
and the type of anger is this anger that
und
is boiling.
I believe, as a church,
that we need some little kind of anger.
Es passieren viele Sachen, die sind
there are
nicht
many
okay
things that are not right.
Sachen, die sind nicht okay in
that are not okay in the church.
Sachen, in unserem Leben, die
things
sind
that
okay.
happen in our life that are not okay. Sometimes it is good to have this holy anger, but not to go to sin. There is this holy anger, this anger that is connected to fight for righteousness and to make things good. Maybe in your companion
A21,
a program that the church does, a bag of goodness, you know, to be angry with people who, to be angry with poverty and try to do good things. I know as a church, we need this passion. You know, because sometimes things become very passive. It is good to be angry, you know, to have this holy anger, to do good things, to be passionate and to do positive things. Does somebody here who understands me? I've preached for a long time.
Und ihr könnt mal aufstehen, die
Band. Let's rise up on our feet. The band can come to the front.
Keine Sorge, ich werde jetzt nicht fragen, wer mit Zorn oder Wut zu
kämpfen. I'm not going to ask you if you're suffering from, if you've been on, been angry for a long time or suffering from anger. But I want to encourage you to ask God. To ask God for help. You know exactly where you need help.
Aber bring's vor Gott.
But bring it to God. Ask for his help. That's the first step to say, hey God, I come to you. And he's going to help you. Maybe you get angry very, very easily in your life. Then you begin to, I want you to pray. Ask God for his help. Maybe you're in a small group. In a small unit. Small group is a wonderful place. You people who can pray with you can hold your hands true to let you let go of that anger.
Maybe you're here. Maybe
you say to yourself, I'm just like that. I'm just an angry person. But I want to tell you, our goal is to be more and more like Jesus. Jesus is our goal. And that's why it's not good that you remain the way you are. Father,
ich danke dir für
I thank you
meine Geschwister hier.
For my brothers and sisters.
Ich danke, dass sie gekommen sind.
I thank you because they come
feiern, um
to celebrate
hören.
You and to hear your word.
Bitten,
I want to pray that,
jetzt durch die Reihen gehst,
that you come
und,
into
und
their life and you give them freedom.
Die negativ sind,
and you let out all the negative energy and anger and all the things that are in their lives that is not good. I thank you because we are not animals. That led by their instincts, but you have made us human beings that we can handle our feelings. I pray for everyone that is in this room that needs help, that they will receive help. I pray for the people in this room who are. They feel powerless.
Ist für sie eine starke Wahrheit.
And for them, they are helpless against this feeling. I pray for this person that, Lord, you will help this person and you show this person the way out. I pray for this person that is always overcome by anger, that you give this person the power to overcome, to become people who have self-discipline, who can control their feelings, and to know that, that their feelings is not always the truth, that they are not their feelings, but they are people who belong to you. I pray that, Lord, you help this person to give them freedom. I pray that, Father, you encourage them because they don't have to do it alone themselves. Lord, I pray for everyone here who are struggling with anger, people who have even done things that they shouldn't have done, and these were not good. I pray that, Father, Lord, you will forgive them for this situation that they found themselves in. If you're here, if you destroyed something and you've hurt people because you were angry, just ask God to forgive you. Because God will set you free. I'm also praying for all those people who have this problem of anger, that the fruit of your spirit is that will come into their life. I pray that, Father, Lord, you will, the fruit of your spirit will blow some in their lives, and they will have this positive energy. I pray that, Father, that you would touch their hearts. And Lord, I pray that, Lord, you will give courage to people here. Lord, I pray for people who have suffered anger from other people, that, Father, you give them courage and you strengthen them to get out of that feeling. That, Father, you will give them the consciousness that they have not deserved it, but they let go of that anger, of that pain. I pray that, Father, Lord, you grant them courage to let go, to speak out, and to let go. I pray that, Father, Lord, you set this one free. Father, I pray that you fill us with joy today, with your Holy Spirit, because you're the one that gives us feelings that can conquer anger in our lives, and that we find peace in you, and we become victorious in you, Jesus, because you live in us, and everyone, that you give every one of us hope in this room, because you change us, because you will change us. And Lord Jesus, we give you all the glory. Amen. Let's give God an applause.